Yo, garin na nami, jojo mo birondo. Yeyo. Yo. Yo garin na nami ha jojo mo bero no garin na nami. Garin na nami ha jojo mo bero no garin na nami jojo mo bero no. Garden na na ha me ha jujja mo bero ho no kayaman morangai kayaman morangai he cha gun gun ganyon go kayaman morangai cha gun gun ganyon go kayaman morangai he cha gun gun ganyon go garden na na me ha jujja mo bero no garden na na me Jamo bero no kopr kopr tai
So this is a native hoop pine. It's a native pine that's from the district, very endemic to the district, doesn't really grow all over Australia, only sort of grows in our districts here, the Sunshine Coast, Moreton Bay districts. They call it the hoop pine. In our language, we call it kunum, kunum. And interestingly, they named people were named after the resin of this tree. Nalbo was the name of the resin. Nalbo was the name of the people. Nalbo was the trade item. It was this resin that comes out of it that was really, really good for fastening your axe heads to your handles, spears, heads to spear shafts, sticky glue. This is the best. And there is an ancient story that talks about its connection with Bunya, that Gagu, thank you Gagu up there, the Kookaburra, Gagu, yeah. He's backing me up here. And so is that Mickey Bird. Hoop pine, kunum, is related to Bunya pine, and Bunya pine and them two are related to the cypress pine, the Bribie Island pine, which, as I said, grow in the same area. Brother to Bunya, father to Bribie. So you'll find them growing in the same area, and when you do find the hoop, always you'll find Bunya right close to it, and Bribie's not too far from them too. And so the story talks about them two being brothers back in the day, having an argument over who was going to wed a woman, fighting over a woman basically. And so their father saw their fighting, and it lasted, it was going on for too long. And the father said, right, I'm going to sort this out, you fellas. Right, you're going to fight it out. He's been arguing, he's going to fight it out, you know. That's how you're going to settle the fight, and whoever wins the fight is going to get the wife. And so they decided they would fight in a spear fight. There's many different styles of fighting, but this one they said, no, we're going to do a spear fight. And so Bunya stood back 20 metres from Kunum. They both stood there. The father was the referee. He said, right, start the throw. So Bunya started throwing them at Kunum, his brother. And he was great at the start. He was dodging a lot of them. He was great, good dodger, but he started getting hit. And where did he get hit? He got hit in the bottom and his legs. He got hit in the legs. All the big spears still stuck in his legs today. But then he had his turn and he started throwing them back. And he hit Bunya, his brother. His Bunya didn't get hit in the legs. Bunya got hit in the shoulders. And so, you know, the story talks about how these trees really got their appearance, where they got their appearance from. Kunum has still got the spears in his legs. Bunya still got the spears in his shoulder. You'll see the Bunya tree at the top has the biggest branches, and on the hoop pines, the biggest branches are on the bottom. If you turn them upside down, they'd be identical. But they are brothers, and the story talks about them being brothers. They had the fight, and nobody won the fight too. Just quietly back to the fight. Nobody won the fight. So the father said, right, none of you has won. I'm taking the woman. And you know, that's the story of how Bunya got his shape, how Kunum got his shape from the spear fight they had fighting over a woman. But we all know Kalula Bribie Pine was the one that took the wife. Yeah. Kunum. Hoop pine.